harassing the police every single day.
Agents who've gone to sex parties with prostitutes or lied to investigators have been able to keep their jobs with Uncle Sam. That's according to the reporting of USA Today newspaper, citing records from the Drug Enforcement Administration in Washington. It reports DEA officials have called for 50 employees to be fired for misconduct in recent years, but only 13 of them have actually lost their jobs. And even dealing drugs is apparently not enough to get you fired from the Drug Enforcement Administration. A DEA spokesman said that the agency often hands out lighter punishments after investigators hear both sides of the story. Kennedy's here. She's host of Kennedy, 8 Eastern, 7 Central on the Fox Business Network.
Shep.
You can't, it's hard to get fired from that DEA.
I was just thinking, this is the branch of law enforcement I'm sure law enforcement officials most want to work for, because you can pretty much do whatever you want. I was looking through a list of some of these charges, covering up a shooting, dealing drugs, sex parties paid for with drug money, with hookers. I couldn't get away with that stuff at Fox, I don't think. I've checked the manual. There's nothing specifically about Colombian hooker-filled sex parties, but I'm pretty certain, even though I'm a civilian, I do not have a badge, I do not carry a gun, I'm not a sworn officer with powers of arrest, but I would get fired for those things. Years, only 13 have been fired. And of those 13, oftentimes they get their jobs back. And it's not just a case of people not being fired. They also aren't stripped of security clearance when they're in trouble. So they could be in deep yogurt, hot water, hot oil, and still have the ability to arrest people and find out naughty, naughty secrets about this great land of ours.
Do you think that they're aware that we lost the drug war already?
I don't think so, because apparently we still have DEA agents in Colombia. It's a lot of money being thrown at a situation that was never made right by the drug war in the first place.
Do we need the DEA?
I don't think so. No, I mean, you know, I've got a bunch of unorthodox ideas about how we should be enforcing some of the laws in this country and what should and should not be illegal. So perhaps if we're focusing on law enforcement, we don't need a DEA, and we should focus on local law enforcement and the FBI when things get really bad.
Having listened to you over time, it's, your position seems to be, if you're not hurting anybody else, what you do to yourself is your business.
Yes.
Now, if you get behind a car or something, the wheel of a car,
you're hurting somebody else, and the police should arrest you and throw you in jail.
But just taking of drugs, no matter what they are, is not something that should be illegal in America.
You know what I've realized in my investigations?
What?
People take drugs every day.
Yeah.
Whether it's hydrocodone for a bad back, whether it's the 6 cups of coffee that many people need before they get to lunchtime, there are so many things we put in our body that alter our performance. And so the question, you know, what are drugs in the first place? We need to ask ourselves that, and are we applying this arbitrary enforcement to various substances?
We are.
I think so.
Well, this morning, a prostitution scandal in the Drug Enforcement Administration is prompting calls to clean house. Agents are accused of attending sex parties funded by drug cartels. The parties allegedly took place between 2005 and 2008, but investigators only found out years later. Chip Reed is outside the Justice Department in Washington with details of the new Inspector General report. Chip, good morning.
Well, good morning. The report looks into numerous allegations of sexual harassment and sexual misconduct at the 4 law enforcement agencies that belong to the Department of Justice. But the allegation that's getting all the attention is that DEA agents had sex parties with Colombian prostitutes over a period of years.
The report says DEA agents attending sex parties in Colombia should have known the prostitutes in attendance were paid with cartel funds, the same drug cartels the officers were supposed to be fighting. To make matters worse, most of the sex parties occurred in government-leased quarters where agents' laptops and BlackBerry devices were present, potentially exposing them to extortion, blackmail, or coercion.
This report demonstrates that the DEA and others, they are engaging in activity that puts our national security at risk.
The report even says that a foreign officer allegedly provided protection for the DEA agents' weapons during the parties. 10 agents were investigated and 7 admitted to DEA investigators that they participated in the sex parties. Their punishment was nothing more than suspensions, ranging from just 2 to 10 days. House Oversight Committee Chairman Jason Chaffetz says that's not enough.
These people should be fired immediately. They need to be held accountable, not just given a 3-day weekend pass.
Prostitution is legal in Colombia in areas known as tolerance zones. And this is not the first time U.S. law enforcement agencies have been rocked by prostitution scandals there. 3 years ago, it was the Secret Service. House Judiciary Committee Chairman Robert Goodlatte says these bad officers can make whole agencies less effective.
There are lots of good, hardworking, dedicated people who are agents in all of these different federal law enforcement agencies. But they're all given a black eye when people are not acting responsibly.
In a written statement, the Justice Department said it already has a zero tolerance policy on sexual harassment and sexual misconduct, and that it is now working with DEA and the other law enforcement agencies to make sure it is enforced. Gail?
All right. Thank you, Chip. There's just something that seems odd about law enforcement officials and sex parties in the same sentence.
Mm-hmm.
Seems like it'd be easy to avoid
drug
that.
Enforcement agents.
In Colombia. Very ironic. In Colombia. Thank you, Chip.
Hey, Sheriff Connie. This is Sheriff Connie Cop Watch. I am using any video here with under fair use. If you have criticism, reporting, teaching, etc., and please donate. I do not make money from YouTube, and there are different ways to donate in the video links. Thanks.